Everybody, it's Aaron Kasnitz out here in Owings Mills, where the Baltimore Ravens are getting ready for one of their most important games in years. If they beat the Cleveland Browns on Sunday, they will be in the playoffs for the first time since 2014. They will win the AFC North for the first time since 2012. If the Ravens lose to the Browns, then they're going to need some help. They'll need the Steelers then to lose to the Bengals. And that's not very likely. So this is really kind of, the Ravens are probably viewing this as a win. You're in the playoffs. Lose, you're not in the playoffs. And if we remember last time the Ravens played the Browns, I was back early October, week 5, the Ravens lost in overtime. Baker Mayfield had an up and down day. The Browns rookie quarterback, he played well at some points, played poorly at others, but he made a big play in overtime on 3rd and 7. He scrambled away and completed a big pass that set up the game-winning field goal. So for the Ravens defense, which is the best in the league, which is coming off a great performance against the Chargers, they've got to play well against Baker Mayfield, not for 40 minutes, not for 50 minutes, for the entire game. Every chance they get, they got to keep Baker Mayfield in the pocket. They got to get to him and bring him down, and they cannot allow him to make big plays when he's scrambling and hitting guys deep downfield. That's what killed them last time. And from the Ravens' perspective on offense, you got to stick with that ground game. It's really been working. Lamar Jackson, Gus Edwards. You don't need to dominate the Browns on the ground because you got such a good defense if you're the Ravens. But you got to score a few points. You got to do better in the red zone and better on the third downs than you did last week. But if the Ravens can establish the run, do well in the red zone and third downs, and if their defense can play even close to the level it's been playing the last few weeks, looks like this team might be in the playoffs again for the first time since 2014.